Welcome to The Quest Card, a Dungeon Master and Player's Source for quests and encounters. We will be covering the three forms of light and dark, the three special visions, obscured effects, and how far the players can see. The basic rules for Dungeons & Dragons are free and you can find them online, either at D&D Beyond or on the Dungeons & Dragons website. I have a link down below if you want to take a look and follow along. Light and darkness comes in three forms: bright light, dim light, and darkness. Daytime, fire, or other vibrant lights fall under bright light, even overcast or gloomy days. Think of this as the area where your vision is not hindered. You could see something clearly in this light. Now, the area between darkness and a bright light source, such as the end of torchlight, some shadows, or even twilight, would be considered dim light. Even a moonlit night, such as on a full moon, would constitute dim light. Think of this as an area where it would be hard to tell if something is a person or a jacket hung up on the wall. When it's nighttime and there is not a full moon, or let's say an unlit dungeon, this is darkness. Think of this as an area where you are effectively blind. What little you can make out is too disorienting. Bright light has no adverse effects unless otherwise noted. Dim light, on the other hand, provides the lightly obscured effect, which provides disadvantage on perception checks that rely on sight, as well as a -5 to passive perception. And finally, darkness provides the heavily obscured effect, which provides the blinded condition. This means they cannot see in the darkness and fail any check to do so. The other important part is that attacks made against the creature suffering from the blinded condition in darkness have advantage. Any attacks made by the blinded creature against any other creature in the darkness have disadvantage if they can guess correctly where they're at. So, what else applies the effects of obscurement? Lightly obscured examples include fog, moderate foliage, and dim light. Heavily obscured examples include opaque fog, dense foliage, and darkness. Different visions alter what causes obscurement, so let's take a look at those. We'll start with the most common, dark vision. This allows players and creatures to see dim light as bright light, nullifying the penalties of the lightly obscured effect caused by dim light. So that means say goodbye to the -5 and disadvantage for perception. It also allows them to see darkness as dim light, nullifying the penalties of heavily obscured effect caused by darkness. This removes the blind penalty when you're trying to see in darkness. However, the typical range of dark vision is only 60 feet, and it allows shades of gray to be seen in your perceivable darkness. Still, everything beyond your range is standard darkness. That means you're just like a human when it comes to vision beyond your range of dark vision. Next up, we have blindsight. This one does not rely on light, since most creatures that have this ability don't have eyesight. They are capable of seeing within a certain range, kind of like a bat. Whatever method it is that gives them blindsight, make sure that it's plausible. You don't have to play by that rule, but it's a fun one. Last, we have true sight. This is by far the most powerful sight. Able to see in darkness, both magical and natural. They are also capable of seeing through illusions, invisibility, and the true form of a shapeshifter, or a creature transformed by magical means. This vision is dependent on your range. The last thing that we'll cover is how far can players and NPCs see. A character can see 2 miles on a clear day with no obstructions, 1 mile for when it's raining, and as low as 100 to 200 feet for fog. If a player is on a hill or mountain, they might be able to see as far out as 40 miles. The application of light, darkness, and vision is important to understand and incorporate in your game. Many spells, abilities, and races have detrimental and beneficial effects to this indicator, and using the rules of light lets people shine in some moments, or up the ante in others. Make sure you have this information ready for each area, or at least remember the standards so that the game moves along smoothly. There's nothing wrong with not having these things ready.